But we see here, what we see here as two signals. The input signal is the channel number one. The output signal is the channel number two, right? So if we go on the experiment now, just to display, we want to see what is the phase difference between these two voltages. What we have seen, we've got many ways of calculating the phase difference, but what we know is that for us to see that there's a phase shift, right? I just want you to see this. Yeah? Looking at this diagram right now, let's make this as big as we can. Yes. You can see that this peak of this signal and the peak of this signal, they are different, right? This peak comes maybe somewhere here. This one comes somewhere here. So it means output voltage, this output voltage is leading actually the input voltage in this case, right? So what we have to do is we have to now check the phase difference. How we check the phase difference? We use knobs called cursor. We use a knob called cursor. We choose two cursors. So there are two types of cursors on the oscilloscope. There's one what we call an amplitude cursor that actually measures the differences in the voltages in the amplitude y-axis. Then there's what we call the time cursor that measures the differences in the x-axis, which is the time axis. So we will just press cursor, right? Then we get onto the type of cursors. I'll just increase this for everyone to see. Then the type of cursors we will choose, not voltage cursors, because these are two voltage cursors, this line and this line. But what we need is the time cursors. We get two cursors in the x-axis. Now we move cursor number one to the maximum of the input voltage. So we move cursor number one to the maximum of the input voltage, right? Maximum of the input voltage, right? Then we move cursor number two, maximum of the output voltage. There we go, right? There we go. Now we have this. Yeah, we've got now this difference. Now what we have is a difference between these two in the second division, which is that 28 microseconds. Yeah, you can see that 28 microseconds. Now that 28 microseconds, we call it delta T. Delta T, right? We call it delta T, right? But then now we need to see what's the relationship between delta T, what's the relationship between delta T and the phase difference, right? So what we know is that this delta T, this axis, this delta change in time is actually changing the period of this signal, right? So this is actually divided by T. If we divide delta T by T, what we find there is just a ratio, right? A unitless number, which is a ratio of the change in the period, just time-wise in the period, right? So if you want to see what was the phase difference in maybe degrees or radians, we have to multiply by the one complete cycle, which is either 2 pi or 360 degrees. So multiply this by 360 degrees. In this way, you will find what is our phase difference. So in this case, if you just go on with this calculation, our delta T became 28 microseconds. 28 microseconds divided by our period, right? Look at it. We're given that we should put a frequency of 10 kilohertz, Our period, relationship between period and frequency, F is 1 over T. So our period actually divided by 1 over 10 kilohertz times 360. If you do this mathematically, you will find what is the phase difference in this case, right? So you find the phase difference in this case. That goes on our question number 3. Now,